Hi friends, in this video let us discuss Tellegen's theorem. Tellegen's theorem means the power delivered in any closed loop equal to 0. I mean sum of the powers in any closed loop is equal to 0. Let us see how this happens. And practically this is represented as sigma n equal to 1 to n, maybe sorry, k equal to 1 to n, vk ik is equal to 0. That means, let me consider a branch here. This is a branch, this is P and this is Q, and the current is, this is the kth branch, so obviously the current would be ik, and which is also equal to IPQ, current passing through it, and the voltage is VK. So here K, VK means voltage across this PQ or voltage at kth branch, IK is current passing through kth branch, and like this there are so many branches in the closed loop. So here I am considering only n branches, so it will be sum of k equal to 1 to n vk ik equal to 0. Now let us see how we can solve this. The solution is very simple. If suppose let me consider vk and ik, which is equal to, so what is vk? Vk is vk and ik is ipq, which can be written as the vk into ip minus iq. Let me call this as equation 1, and I can simply write the same thing as vk into I'm sorry, there is a mistake here. This is kth branch, so voltage is Vk, and this can be defined as Vk is equal to Vp minus Vq. So voltage at P minus voltage at Q, and the current is Ik, which is equal to Ipq. Okay, this is the thing. So if Vk and Ik is equal to, multiplication of these two would be Vp minus Vq into Ipq. Okay, this is one equation, and the second equation would be Vk Ik can also be written as Vq minus Vp, that means it's reverse order, and Iqp, Qp means current passing in the opposite direction. This is IQP. So this is one minus will come up, and in this way one other minus will come up. Minus into minus it will be plus. So this is also correct thing. Now I like to add these two equations. It will be 2VK IK is equal to VP minus VQ into IPQ plus VQ minus VP into IQP. So this is the thing. This is the power for one branch. Now let us make up with n number of branches. So k equal to 1 to n 2 vk ik. So let us make this 2 here. So it will be like this, is equal to 1 by 2 into sigma p equal to 1 to n. Okay, and there may be, there are n branches, so it will be like this. It will be Vp minus sigma p equal to 1 to n sigma q equal to again 1 to n Vp minus Vq into Ipq plus So this part is over, and coming to this part, so same thing will come up. So sigma p equal to 1 to n, again sigma q equal to 1 to n, it will be v q minus v p into I q p. This is simple. So this is the equation. Now let us split these two things, this one and this one, so into these things. So let me write here. Okay, I am writing here, please kindly follow. So sigma k equal to 1 to n vk ik is equal to 1 by 2 into sigma p equal to 1 to n vp sigma q equal to 1 to n ipq minus again sigma, now vq will come, so q equal to 1 to n vq sigma p equal to 1 to n ipq. So that is for, that is explanation for this part. So there are two parts, multiplication of these two. So here you can see multiplication of these two is over. Again minus, so these two are splitted into vp ipq minus vq ipq. So vp ipq means this is for vp, so up to one it has only p, so sigma is only p. For ipq it is having two, p and q, so this will, this and this are applicable. Okay, please kindly see this. So once it is over, the other part would be the same. So it will be sigma p equal to 1 to n. So first q will come here, so q equal to 1 to n vq sigma p equal to 1 to n I qp minus sigma p equal to 1 to n vp sigma q equal to 1 to n I q p. So these are the things, but according to Kirchhoff's current law, the I p q is equal to sigma I p q is equal to 0. So all these things will be 0. See, wherever this part is 0, this part will be 0, and this part will be 0, and this part will be 0. So at the end, therefore sigma k equal to 1 to n vk ik is equal to 0. So this is the explanation for Tellegen's theorem. Yeah, Tellegen's theorem means the power delivered, sum of the powers delivered in any closed loop at any point of time is equal to 0. So here I have taken only one branch, kth branch we have taken, and it is running from P to Q. So the current is IK, that can be called as IPQ also, and voltage is VK. VK means VP minus VQ. VP minus VQ. So I want to take the power here. So VK IK is equal to VP minus VQ into IPQ. VK minus VK IK is equal to VQ minus VP into IQP. So these two are interchangeably written, because here IPQ is equal to minus IQP. So this is the thing. So we can write here. So now we need to add these two equations. So once these two equations have been added, so I got the power in kth branch. So but I want these, Tellegen's theorem is sum of the powers delivered in closed loop. So in closed loop there may be so many branches. So this is for kth branch, so I need to make it up for n number of branches, and I need to sum it up according to the Tellegen's theorem. So sigma summation of this part, and these are the things. So summation of these two, and simply division of summation. So we have used here according to KCL, all these things will be zero. Sum of currents in a sum of currents equal to zero. So obviously that will be all currents will current parts will be zero. So this is the final result, and this is sum of power in any branch equal to zero at any point of time. So this is the Tellegen's theorem. If you have any doubts, please post in the comment box so that I can reply with proper answers. And if you like this video, please like it and kindly share this video with your friends. Thank you. Thank you so much.